there's a new technology that's touted to change the way we live forever.
Imagine you put on your glasses or headset and you're instantly in your home space.
The internet will end as we know, and it will totally reshape the global economy.
Facebook is betting $10 billion and its future on it.
Together, we can finally put people at the center of our technology and deliver an experience where we are present with each other.
Other tech giants like Microsoft, Apple, and Nvidia are also banking on this being the next big thing.
Challenge us with new ways of seeing.
A limitless 3D digital world running parallel to ours.
But if you thought this might just be a passing fad, you might be able to ignore it, you better think again.
Its market value is predicted to be over $800 billion by 2025. But its supporters reckon it has the potential to hold the majority of all the wealth in the world. And early investors are already piling in.
Welcome to the future of the internet.
And people haven't really figured this out yet. But again, it's going to be an enormous generator of wealth.
But this isn't just a futuristic vision out of sci-fi films like Ready Player One.
It's an inevitability. It's happening already.
And it's growing.
This is the dimension of imagination.
This is the metaverse. And this is how it could change the world. April 2020. The height of the COVID-19 pandemic. The entertainment industry was decimated.
Concerts are canceled.
It's easy to see why the music industry has been singing the blues during this pandemic.
Several shows are on hold right now.
At least in the so-called real world. But there was one concert that attracted a larger crowd than the 20 biggest gigs of all time combined.
Where's Travis?
Fans entered the video game Fortnite as avatars and got up close to rap legend Travis Scott performing live.
No way, dude! That's so cool!
The best sold Travis Scott's physical event could hold 180,000 people, while the Fortnite equivalent held 11 million people. The show was magically done, was fully immersive.
Just like in the real world, festival goers went to great lengths to stand out from the crowd, buying so-called skins for their avatars. Along with other digital merchandise, the music star netted a reported $20 million. It's rewards like this that have got the tech giants excited. The rebranding of Facebook and its stable of companies, including Instagram and WhatsApp, is a bid to put it at the center of this revolution.
Our company is now Meta.
Whoa-ho!
We're gonna talk about the future, starting with the most important experience of all, connecting with people.
In this slightly awkward video, Mark Zuckerberg provided a glimpse of what the metaverse could look like.
It was, you know, a bit too produced, I would say. Mark Zuckerberg's choice of clothes was a bit traditional.
Perfect.
I think in the metaverse, there is much more space to explore creativity and self-expression.
Hey, what's going on?
Hi.
What's up, Mark?
Whoa, we're floating in space?
Uh-huh.
Who made this place? It's awesome.
Zuckerberg's vision is that people will be completely immersed in the metaverse through VR headsets and smart glasses. Leading the headset market is Oculus, owned by, you guessed it, Facebook. Meta. Oh, you know what I mean.
The metaverse is something that it's in everyone's mouth at the moment. I mean, the question is, what is the metaverse?
Think of it as the next generation internet. Picture the web as 2D, like a load of city blocks, platforms like Twitter and Facebook, where everyone's crammed in. The metaverse is a 3D evolution of this, but it works differently. It's created all around us, where everything is interlinked. It's built on blockchain technology. Think of it more like a fleet of high-speed cabs bursting out of the city on an endless, omnidirectional superhighway.
When internet started, some people knew about it, and as of suddenly, we all were using it. And we are exactly at that moment with what we call Web 3.0 or Metaverse. And I believe that by 2025, it's just part of our lives.
And whereas on websites and social media, your identity is reduced to an uninspiring username or thumbnail image, in the Metaverse, as imagined in Ready Player One, you're a customizable avatar.
Yeah, that's me. Well, that's my avatar. At least until I feel like changing.
You can be anything you want in the Metaverse.
You can start a new identity from scratch. It doesn't really matter who you are in real life.
But don't expect a single eureka to kick things off.
I've got it! He's got it!
The Metaverse is constantly evolving. There are fragments already all around us.
The gaming industry is an early adopter of what the Metaverse could look like.
It's 3D, it's immersive. The fact that you can earn, the fact that you can play, the fact that there are microeconomies.
From Second Life to Minecraft, Roblox and Fortnite, the experience of living, shopping, selling and earning in digital worlds has been around for decades.
Oh, I got a rainbow bear!
But this is embryonic. It's dial-up compared to fiber optic broadband. It's a ZX spectrum compared to the PS5.
The games that we're familiar with, they aren't really metaverses, and it really comes down to one factor. They're not interoperable. What that means is that if you buy something in a specific game, you can't really use it in a different part of the metaverse.
The real prize that a fully formed metaverse has to offer is an entirely new digital economy that's decentralized. A new breed of games are already demonstrating how this will work.
Decentraland is probably the first example of a truly decentralized social community in the metaverse. You can own things, you can buy, you can trade, you can meet up. There is no company behind it. It's owned by the community.
And the go-to currency is ETH, because most of these new world games are built on Ethereum blockchain. With this and other cryptos, players can pay for digital products in what is fast becoming an entirely new economy.
The Christie's auction for digital artist Beeple coming to a close a few moments ago.
Final sale price, $69.3 million. That's more than most Picassos, Monets, or Warhols.
The trading in digital collectibles via NFTs will be key to the economy of the metaverse. An NFT, or a non-fungible token, is something that can be bought with cryptocurrency. It's basically a piece of code proving that you own a certain digital asset, securing its authenticity and scarcity. This doesn't have to be art. It could be real estate, music, clothing, entertainment, anything that can be represented digitally. This NFT sits on a blockchain and can be bought and sold in an online marketplace. Tech-savvy celebs are getting in on the act. Quentin Tarantino is auctioning off 7 uncut scenes from his iconic movie Pulp Fiction on the NFT marketplace OpenSea.
This is a tasty burger.
Some NFTs can be tied to items in the real world. Mila Kunis's new animated TV show is fully NFT funded, as she told Conan O'Brien.
In quarantine, some people took up baking and knitting, and I deep dived into crypto and NFTs.
The NFT you buy gives you ownership of a digital image of one of the cats, which can be used as a ticket to watch the TV show. Keeping in with the Metaverse in-crowd, the film star even got Ethereum creator Vitalik Buterin to voice one of the cats. NFTs are increasingly everywhere, even making waves on the catwalk. Leading the way is Dutch fashion label The Fabricant. They don't weave or sew, they make digital-only garments for avatars in the Metaverse. Sold as, that's right, NFTs.
Dressing yourself in the digital realm is going to be as important or even more important than in the physical life. You can go completely crazy in your own identity curation. You can wear a fire jacket without getting burned. you can be a dinosaur for a day.
It's no wonder that big clothing names are following suit.
Nike is getting in on the NFT craze, filing several trademarks for virtual goods.
The future of fashion will be digital-only fashion. We're going to have a very small physical wardrobe because our fashion is going to be augmented in our lives.
But NFTs aren't the only way to make money in the metaverse.
The Philippines imposed one of the world's longest lockdowns, but it led to one of the country's worst economic recessions.
With unemployment at around 17%, people have been forced to find more creative ways of paying the bills. They flocked to playing Axie, a game where players can make money.
The most inspiring thing is the fact that the same people where society failed were able to make a living that was even bigger salary-wise than they were in the real world.
Some gamers are reportedly earning between $500 and $800 a month from battling and trading Axie characters. That's double the national living wage in the Philippines.
It democratizes the world. We now don't have to travel anymore. There's really a global playing field where people can earn money no matter where they are.
COVID has transformed the way the vast majority of people now work. Doing our jobs on Zoom and Google Meet has become as comfortable as the pajamas we wear during the working day now. In the metaverse, this will be supersized. And I don't just mean better pajamas.
My job involves a lot of traveling. In the future, I could see myself going from London to Australia to Singapore all in one go within a couple of hours, just by switching rooms in the metaverse.
It's just mind-blowing to me.
And in this future, school's out, at least as we know it. The structure of education has barely changed in centuries. But in the metaverse, classrooms could look very different.
Let's take a closer look. What part of the solar system are we talking about?
Saturn.
If you're studying about the Roman Empire, and you can be in the Roman Empire, the absorption of that information is going to be much higher.
I don't know if my kids in the future will attend a university or will just go from different metaverse to try and learn what they need for this new world.
Crucially, the same quality of education could be available to every human on the planet. So what's it going to take for mass adoption in the metaverse?
It can only really materialize when three things happen: software, hardware, and demand. Demand-wise, we're definitely ready for the metaverse. If you just look at the gamers, we've got about 3.2 billion gamers in the world.
The gaming industry also provides the backbone of metaverse software, such as Fortnite's Unreal Engine, or the Unity engine that powers Pokemon Go. So what about the hardware?
From a hardware perspective, I don't think we are quite there yet. We need it to be seamless. I don't want to wear big goggles and run around in my living room with those. I want something that doesn't intrude my day-to-day.
But metaverse-ready smart glasses are coming down the track at speed.
Yeah, be prepared. This is going to be the new reality. Not digital, not physical, but digital. We're going to be living enhanced digital lives, and it's transformational. And it's coming.
The thing is, though, anyone who has seen The Matrix knows digital utopias don't always work out.
Get me the hell out of here!
Welcome to the real world.
Is it possible, just possible, that we should be a touch wary about the metaverse?
If we're spending all of our time online, there's a social disconnect. We learn so much by interacting with other humans, and this may have a massive impact on mental health.
But there's no getting away from the fact this is mind-blowing technology that, whether you like it or not, will change the way people interact, communicate, work, and socialise.
I've just taken a photograph with a thought process. This is incredible.
In the next decade, alternate reality will become our new reality.
Our next film will explain how Ethereum is central to the growth of the metaverse. Hit the subscribe button and we'll alert you when it lands. In the meantime, you can download the Currency.com trading app through the QR code. Thank you for watching.